Okay, next slide, radiology supervision and interpretation. This has been a perennial confusing topic, and I was admitting to Alicia tonight that I had been teaching for 3 years before I finally got this. So I say that to make you feel, you know, okay, if you don't get everything, you still can pass the exam. You don't have to know everything. And this is definitely an area that confuses people. And notice it says supervision and interpretation, not interpretation and report. That's why these get confused. So the question is, could you please illustrate with an example, preferably a problem of your choice when radiation supervision interpretation codes are applicable? Thanks, Marty. So here's an example that Alicia found, intravascular ultrasound of noncoronary vessel, radiological supervision and interpretation due to renal artery stenosis. So this came out of one of our workbook exercises. And when you look up the code in the index, it points you to 75945. And when you read the description of that in CPT, intravascular ultrasound, non-coronary vessel, radiological supervision and interpretation, initial vessel. Okay, so what is this supervision and interpretation? Let's go to the next slide. Here is a copy and paste of the guidelines in radiology on page 361, if you're using the 2012 professional version, that tells us what it is. Go to your guidelines, okay? And I call this two codes are needed to tell the story for some radiological procedures. Years and years ago, way before I even started studying coding, apparently there were these single codes that told the story of, say, I don't know, starting a catheter and manipulating up to a point to inject dye and the imaging. Really, that's two pieces. That's a surgical piece, right? Cutting into the patient and inserting and manipulating a catheter, and then the radiology piece. And what was happening, you know, an interventional radiologist is what they're called, would do both pieces. That's why they're called an interventional radiologist. But they didn't always do two pieces. Sometimes you had a surgeon type guy doing the surgery piece, and you had the radiologist doing the supervision and interpretation piece. So what they decided to do, because it was different for every single situation, how to split the fee, they just said, forget it. We're not going to let them share the CPT code. We're going to have two separate codes. Okay. So one was for the surgical piece. And I say surgical, I don't mean like major surgery, but, you know, cutting into the body, inserting something, normally injecting dye. And the other piece was the radiology supervision and interpretation piece. So whenever you see that phrase, that's all that means is that, hey, I'm part of a two-code story. If you did the other part, code that too. Okay? So with that in mind, let's read the official definition. When a procedure is performed by two physicians, the radiologic portion of the procedure is designated as radiological supervision and interpretation. When a physician performs both the procedure and provides imaging supervision and interpretation, a combination of procedure codes outside the 70,000 series and imaging supervision and interpretation codes are to be used. Okay, so when they say outside the 70,000 series, they mean those surgery type codes. Okay, so the bottom line is SNI, supervision and interpretation, is not interpretation and report. They're two different things. Interpretation and report is what starts us thinking, oh, professional component, modifier 26. Okay. That's a whole different issue. Okay. So supervision and interpretation, I'm part of a two code story.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.